Keep that there. Let's keep that elevated.
But isn't that interesting?
Just keep that elevated there.
They don't, there's,
Oh, no, I would only embarrass
myself.
Come on.
It's such a You gotta try.
I really don't
it's
think
fun.
It's a good
Come on.
Idea.
I'll even show you the famous Craverston grip, okay?
Craverston grip.
Hold on.
All right.
Like a pencil. Even
like
pressure
this?
There. Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Now, cock your wrist back. Yeah. Elbow out.
Yeah.
Kind of.
I think I can find it.
You're doing a great
job. Like here,
right?
Rehearsal's up.
Yeah. Is that better?
Love it. Love it.
You see which one's doing?
Like, I don't want to go for dessert.
Right. Kind of mix it up. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. I want to
Sooner. And then when you get here, I'm probably going to call Susan. And then if she's not... What would I say?
No fingerprints. When people move out of their house, they always change the front door, lock, but they never change the garage remote. And Dave and Bridget gave it to me when they went to Myrtle Beach, and they asked me to feed Smokey, and I forgot to give it back. Now, are you coming?
No.
I forgot to give it back after Dave and Bridget went to Myrtle Beach, and they asked me to feed Smokey. Are you coming? You're gonna need to cover your hands.
I'm gonna do a wide shot of it too, so we could cut takes
okay,
together.
Okay, great. So thank you.
I wasn't
so bitterly disappointed.
No, it was hilarious. Are you kidding me?
Oh, great.
Ways to carry a human being that are not firemen.
Yeah, like this.
Yeah.
That's nice.
There's that.
But it's just as probably heavier on the arms and back. Is it? What's the heaviest?
Over the shoulder.
What about just the drag?
Over the shoulder is.
What about
easier.
The drag?
Yeah.
What you just did in the arm carry, right?
Yeah.
Then pick her up here. Sorry, if you'll just stand.
I will. Sorry, I'm not gonna hurt you. Sorry.
And then
I think in a bear hug. I think
like
facing
this,
you.
Facing. And then if we kind of walk together, like.
Oh, like we're pretending that I'm on your feet. Oh, good.
Yes.
Yeah. Does that work?
I thought Julian was supposed to be friendly.
You ordered well.
That's a great line.
Go back there, Jeff. We need you.
speed and we're ready, H.
Okay,
stay
there.
Okay, here we go.
No, they asked me to stay out.
How we doing back there, Jeff? We need you.
Glad you made it. You have any trouble finding the place?
No, I'm a little ticklish right there. Sorry. The henchmen were very helpful.
Aren't they? And this must be the wife. Wow, you guys really dressed up for tonight.
Well, we don't get out very often, so when we do, we really like to make the most of it. And Mikey and Patrick are at camp, so I had my hair blow dried. And
me too.
Get in there.
B-Mark.
Camera set. And action.
Please sit. Have some champagne.
Okay.
I like champagne.
Look at these guns. It's the real deal, isn't it?
Pictures up. I think Mark and Greg, you know, had a lot of serious conversations about the script was pretty straightforward relative to, production design and art direction. Most of our sets were, you know, a basement or a hotel room, or it's pretty straightforward design aspects. But I know that, especially for the hotel suite, Mark really elevated the design since it was such an important part of the film. Well, we have a fantastic set decorator, Rena D'Angelo. For the Gaffney house, you know, it was a little more homey and lived in. Obviously, they had, I think in the story, been there for over a decade and had children. So there were a lot of layers. She worked from home, so her office was a kind of a fun set for Rena and her team to dress. The Joneses was slicker, the color palette was a little more modern. The dressing was more modern, and it wasn't as lived in, obviously. They had just moved in, not as many layers, but kind of a slicker, subtle design scheme. The most fun in the cul-de-sac was probably seeing the neighborhood embrace the changes we made. That was from a logistical, it sounds kind of boring in a sense, but we did a lot of good things, and a lot of the yards were kind of not in the best shape. So we came in and, pretty much any house that you saw on camera, we put some paint on, added sod, added a tree. So the neighbors were really starting to see what little tiny, or not so tiny sometimes, but what design changes and even simple gardening things could really elevate the neighborhood. Well, this is my fifth feature in Atlanta, and I find it a very hospitable place to shoot. The locations on this particular film, one of the most important ones was our MBI, where Jeff Gaffney works, and we ended up using a Chinese company called Saini, south of the city, in Peachtree City. Beautiful modern building. So happens that there's very few employees at this facility, so we were really able to maximize their space and get a lot of production value there. And that was really helpful to help sell that he worked at a big kind of defense, cloak and dagger-esque type place. So that was really interesting, but we had to They had an existing sign at Saney, which was made out of foam, and it was basically double-sticked to this really modern building. They had foam letters, which surprised all of us that they, but it made it easy to switch out the signage, and that was a benefit of them having a strangely inexpensive sign on such a massively, you know, modern building. The chase scenes were pretty intense, and my department had a good bit of contribution to that, because as they started to really figure out how these motorcycles and the Mercedes and all these things would come together, new ideas were invented, and some of those were crashing vehicles and motorcycles through big bay doors. So we really had to match to the location, which meant some intricate balsa and rubberized like hinges, and really kind of, you know, just obviously to protect the actors, but we still had to, you know, make it realistic so it would look like they were crashing through real old rusty, you know, bay doors. We also built an office, an old, you know, because this was our old MBI, which is in contrast to the new MBI in Peachtree City. So between the older style graphics, the idea was that this MBI closed 30 years ago. So we had a beautiful 70s era graphic on top of this, you know, old kind of warehouse. But we also built an office that a Mercedes crashes through. And that was kind of fun to build balsa bookshelves and papers everywhere. And so it was kind of fun creating that world for them, for stunts and everyone to crash through. Now, when we work with the stunt team, we are very cognizant of safety first and, you know, what works best for them, and balancing that with the right material to achieve, you know, the look that we're after. So if something needs to look metal, you know, we need to make sure that it looks metal but is safe for the actors. So there's a lot of collaboration with the stunt department.
Hi, Vale here with more on comedy for you. Now, when you think of comedy, you don't necessarily link comedy movies to the Oscars. In fact, very rarely have comedy films won the Best Picture Oscar. The following have been the only comedies that have won Best Picture. It Happened One Night from 1934. You Can Take It With You from 1938. The musical comedy Going My Way from 1944. Tom Jones from 1963. The Sting from 1973. And Annie Hall from 1977. There are other borderline or hybrid comedies that have won the award, including The Apartment from 1960, Terms of Endearment from 1983, Driving Miss Daisy from 1989, Forrest Gump from 1994, Shakespeare in Love from 1998, and two dark comedies, American Beauty from 1999 and Birdman from 2014. What's your favorite comedy movie? Let me know in the comments below, and remember to subscribe to our channel for the all best comedy movie releases.